full of suffering. Sometimes you were publicly exposed to insult and persecution. At other times, you stood side by side with those who were so treated. You suffered along with those in prison and joyfully accepted confiscation of your property, because you knew that you yourselves had better and lasting possessions. So do not throw away your confidence. It will be rightly rewarded. You need to preserve, so that when you have done the will of God, you will receive what He has promised. Hallelujah. Let me just quickly lay down a quick very foundation. Now, the book of Hebrew, we understand that, as the theologian said, they don't know really who wrote the book. But those who know would have the Holy Spirit, we understand, was Paul that wrote it. And the purpose of writing a book was, the early Christians came from Judaism. After making a decision of following Jesus and going through persecution and, you know, all the pains, they were double-minded. We have been wondering, did we make the right decision following Jesus? And even some turned back. It was this morning as I woke up, the Lord is reminding many of us were so complaining. Why? Because things are not working in the way they should work. Or people who are around us, the way they're treating us, we're just like giving up. But remember, He who has called you is faithful. He is faithful. He never leaves. He never will forsake you. Yes, we understand you go through all the problems around you. Listen, He's still faithful.
Amen.
He is not blind. He sees and He knows. In fact, as somebody said, as you are going through your problem, He's with you. Amen. Let me put it this way. The Lord is my shepherd. Now, we understand David was a man that went through a lot. Yet he boldly stood up and said, the Lord is my shepherd.
Yes.
Amen. So regardless of what you're going through, listen, He is still your shepherd.
Amen.
Nothing should change you because of what you're going through. I know many of you, you've been so complaining, feel like giving up. Listen, whatever you're going through, just a way the Lord may be use you to build up your character, be strong.
Yes.
To be very strong. Mm-hmm. Yes, you have not been paying attention, and that's why they go to over and over again. Mm-hmm. 35. So do not throw away your confidence. Why? It will be rewarded. Don't throw away your confidence.
Amen.
Don't. Our God is faithful. Yes, you just came a long way. Don't give up. Don't give up no matter what. Why? Because God is able.
Amen.
He's able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can ask and even think. He's so much able. So don't give up. Many of us, we sin. If we start questioning ourselves now, did I have made the right decision to follow Jesus? We look at my friend that with the living life, with things they have. Listen, one thing you're forgetting, that day you were made Jesus as your Lord and Savior, hell break loose against you. That's why sometimes feel like you want to give up, go back. No. What happened? Your enemy is so scared of you.
Amen.
But right. Unfortunately, most Christians don't know what the decision was made.
Yes.
He's so scared, but the only way for him to reveal his sins is to attack you.
Yeah.
But those who know their God,
hallelujah,
no matter what he does, those who know their God, now we can go to all the Old Testament, those who know their God, Daniel stood, because I'm not going to bow down, God came to the rescue.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, if you stand for Jesus, he will never leave you.
Amen.
He will stand with you as well.
Amen.
But if you forsake him, guess what? You're going to feel the pain. No matter what happened in your life, never give up. Stand with him. He will never let you down.
Amen.
Never, no matter what. He is faithful.
Amen.
He is faithful. When he say, I will do it, he will do it.
Amen.
So that's the word I just had this morning. But I was wondering, what do I have to give a word of encouragement, or encouragement, what to say? The Lord just remind me, tell my people, I'm still faithful.
Amen.
I am still faithful. Trust me, many of us, many, even most of Christians, they are already gone. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're sitting, yes, we worship Jesus, but our heart has already returned back. Mm-hmm. Long ago, it's not what happened to the Israel. They were walking with the Lord, but their heart was looking back. Mm-hmm. And that's what happened to most of us. Mm-hmm. Yes, we're here worshiping, lift your hands, but listen, check your heart. Mm-hmm. Are you really walking with Him 100%? Mm-hmm. Or are you just, no, let me just follow the crowd, you know, and then, listen, you'll be disappointed when you stand before the Lord. Listen, depart from me. Mm-hmm. In the series. Now, those who say depart from him, guess what? There were people who knew him. They said, depart from what? Because I once knew you. But no more. Stand strong. He never promised us that whatever, as you're born again, you're going to have a bed full of roses. Never. But you can go to a lot. But behold, I've given you peace.
Amen.
He has overcome the world.
Amen.
So walk in his footsteps. Amen. Follow him. Follow him. I know as I'm speaking, I can hear some already. You already question yourself. Am I making the right decision? Am I making the right decision? But yeah, stand strong.
Amen.
Stand strong. Stand strong.
Amen.
Stand strong. Things may go upside down in your workplace. Things may go upside down with your partners. Things may go upside down every area in your life. Remember, Jesus is always with you. Don't doubt him. Don't give up. Be strong. I really feel like preaching, but I said, nah, I'm just giving a word of encouragement because I want my brother to preach. So just quick word of encouragement.
Amen.
Stay strong.
Amen.
Stay strong.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Stay strong.
Amen.
If what we need now is don't give up, stay strong.
Right.
We're in the last days where many have given up because they didn't have enough money. Many have given up because the sickness not overtake them. Many have given up because all kind of issues.
Hey.
Why? Because we enter that this is the last days.
Hey.
So it's not about how you have started, how you give me life. But how are you going to finish?
That's right.
So that's why the enemy is pressing you down.
Yeah.
To make you quit. But yeah. Stand strong.
Yeah.
Don't,
yeah.
Give up.
Yeah.
Don't give up.
No.
Don't give up.
No.
I'll keep it very short.
Yeah.
Now, I will do that. Call my brother to come and preach. Lord Jesus.
Amen.